start putting my bathroom this morning. I'm trying to figure out what to wear. I have 3 events today and I'm like, okay, what is this? 2 days prior, I knew what I was going to wear. And then this morning, Laura said, no, change. I said, I wore some clothes just recently. You know, you don't like to repeat your clothes because Facebook will tell you that your members are in 20 city works. I said, you know what, I'm going to do it because there is a shift that's going to come to you. It was not about me. It was just for me to tell you about the shift that God is going to do in your life,
amen,
in your ministry. Don't let this do anything to your mind. Don't let this be where, oh, you know what, it is not happening. The Bible says we're two or three are dead. It was not new that in times like these on a Saturday morning when we would want to have 100 women or 200 women come together to be in his presence, you know, to just magnify him, they'll be otherwise minded. So I want you to know and to understand that God sees your heart.
Yeah.
A lot of things that I know about you, you don't even know I know. But I'm just telling you that you hide it so well, like many of us. People see certain things that you see, but they only knew half of the other things that you go through that nobody knows. And I'm sure many of us are going through right now. So many things because the battlefield of mind is real.
Yes.
So I'm not the one here holding this, but I know many of us, if we've ever had a relationship, we've had domestic violence. Because we know how it is, men and women will say things to you. It's not about the physical, it's also about the emotional. In Jamaica, they said a man here alone. That means that man had a woman with you. And sometimes you know, you try to put a face on. But let me tell you something today. The God that I serve will vindicate you. The God that I serve will make sure if you stay in his will, you will see his goodness. And I can tell you this because I experienced this just this week. So I know the God that I serve, the God that you serve, and the God that each and every one of us serve. Where do I start? I used to be at Bank of America as a mortgage executive, and the Lord called me full-time ministry. And I didn't know how my bills were going to be paid because, come on, you're making $240,000 a year. Who wants to walk away from that to go, say, go to different countries? Or I didn't even know where God was sending me because I didn't have a dollar. But my alma mater, my sister, my friend, my high school friend, who surprised me to be here today, Sharon from the Faith Center, Girl Time, Janice, I mean, it's just like I posted this and I just don't know who's going to come. I stopped typing. But the fact is that I try to support, I try to, when I can't be there physically, I'm there in the spirit and I'm praying. And that's what I'm going to ask each and every one of you today to do, to pray. You know, we pray and pray that God is Jesus. But I mean, seriously pray in this season. Because so many of us are just losing our minds. Not just, you know, getting mental breakdown, but there's just so much going on. I just had to burn my dad. I had to preach at his funeral. I had to put him down in the ground because the pastor said, oh, I've done anything. I've done everything. The strength that I have is from God. The bones that I have is from God. And if you really, truly just take the time to really see what it is that he wants to do in our life. As you said, purpose is important. That purpose is a brokenness because many of us are broken right now. I know Connie said, I don't know why I'm here today. But you're here today only because God wanted you here to hear these stories. So you, and I'm putting our blocks in this, and I do that because she needs to start her ministry. And she's just sitting on it and not doing it. And many of us, we're here doing our ministry, but there's so much more that God wants from us as women, as men. Because it's not about just us today, because men are also abused. I abused my husband a little bit, you know. But, you see, you know, what God is getting ready to do for you and your ministry. You might not see it right now in the natural, but the legacy is in your children also. And I was late for an award last night. Last night I got an award and I went there to give an award. I thought I was giving an award and I received an award. And I was late because I was feeling the less fortunate. And so I don't take any pity for myself or what God has called me to. Because if it wasn't for him, I could not do it. Honestly, I don't know how my $2,500 mortgage is going to be paid. I don't know. And I'm not calling you yet tomorrow, but maybe. Let's see what God is going to do. So it's only Joe. Jared provides for me. And if you are called, I said this last time, if you are called to ministry, stop questioning what God wants you to do. Just make that move. He will send me a life. Like, I met her last week at an event. And she actually came in my car for you. I got a Marc Jacobs perfume. She didn't know that my perfumes were almost out. And she had that walking in her car for many, 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 many. Since Christmas, I don't know if it was my birthday. Yeah, you know, so God will send that person. You'd be surprised. So, woman and men of God, if there's anything that God has been tugging on your spirit and telling you to do, do not wait. Do not wait. Now is the time. People are just dying. At least let them be able to say something at your funeral. I should serve in some form of capacity. Because we all have some kind of purpose in us. And so today I want to tell you how much I thank you for this. I don't take it lightly. I'm honored. My domestic violence is just so many. But I remember, like it was yesterday, every time for that one particular relationship, every time you would come see me, I would just put my head like this, because I know it's going to get a fist on my forehead. So I would leave most times with, you know, in Jamaica, what do you call it, Coco in Jamaica. I thank God that I still have my mind, even though, you know, that happened to me. What about the emotional ones? I can't even run enough time for them. But I thank God that there's places on your heart, because many of us did not put a purple heart, but we wanted to put 10 purple hearts because of what we're going through now, what we went through before. And I thank God that we have platforms like these where we can share and we can let others know that, you know what, there is hope.
Watch God.
Amen.